Welcome to Chatterbox Quilts. I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst, and today I want to show you how to bind a quilt. So there's a few things you need to know, but the first thing I want to mention to you is that I have another video that shows you how to join the binding ends without using a tool, because today I'm going to be showing how to join the binding ends using the binding tool. So if you want to see the other video, where you don't need any tool at all, but it's just showing you how to join the binding ends, check up above or in the description below, because I'll put a link to that video. Okay, most of our quilts are square or rectangular, so this method works really well for those. If you have a quilt that is not square or rectangular, has a different, you know, like it's a polygon or something, let's say, you're going to be using a different kind of binding, okay? You're going to be using not the straight edge binding we're talking about today, so that's not this video, okay? But this is the traditional way to bind our kind of standard square or rectangular quilts. And the first thing you need to know is, what is the size? What is the perimeter of that quilt? So I'm going to measure one side, which is 45 inches. Then I'm going to turn that quilt and measure the other side and see what that is. And that's about 36 inches. So if you add the two of those together, you get, because I've already done the math for us, 81 inches. Now you want to multiply that by two, and that gives you 162 inches. So that's the perimeter of the quilt. That means we need that much binding. But how do we figure that out? Okay. So we're going to be cutting strips at 2.5 inches, and I need to know how many strips to cut to join together that it's going to be enough to go around this quilt. So what I do is I take the number I just calculated, the perimeter, 162 inches, and I multiply that times 0.0254. Okay, don't ask me about the math here. It just works. Trust me. Okay, so when you've multiplied that out, what you get is 4.1. So whenever you have a decimal after the number, you're going to round up. So in other words, instead of 4, I'm going to go up to 5. Okay, I know it's not the usual way we do the rounding, but just trust me on this one too. So what that means is that I need to cut 5 strips that are 2.5 inches by width of fabric. Once I've got those strips cut, I want to make sure that I join them together with mitered seams, so a 45 degree angle on those seams. It makes it less obvious where the joins are on the binding fabric. And you want to make sure when you're joining the strips together that you cut off your selvages, okay? You don't want to have selvages in there. So once you've got all that long piece, those strips all joined together, is going to be a really long piece of thin fabric. What you want to do is you want to fold that fabric along the length, okay? So you're going to fold it in half along the length, and you're going to press it all down so it's nice and flat. And once you've done that, what you get is this. So you've got this, you know, long, long strip. You can see that I've got it folded in half here. Okay, so you have it folded in half. Nice. Nice and ready to be applied to your quilt. That's the next thing we need to talk about. When I am putting binding on my quilt, I like to start at one of the sides. So in this case, the long measurement would be the side. I'm just going to put my measurements back there so I don't end up sewing them into the quilt or something. And you want to, before you start, you want to make sure, first off, you got to find the end, which in my case, I'm having difficulties. There we go. Okay. I did have this all wound up very nicely, but I need to pull it out to show you things anyway. So I want to take my binding strip. It's folded in half. I want to leave about a 10 inch tail, and I like to start it somewhere along the side of the quilt. Okay. So I would just put it here. I'm going to pin it in place here. Okay, and this is what I like to do first. I like to mock up the binding, okay? I do not want to have the seams in the binding. And by the way, I forgot to mention you should fold those or iron those open, I should say, for less bulk. And I want to make sure that those mitered seams, there's one here, does not fall at a corner, okay? Because that's going to create too much bulk, and that's not good. So I like to take my binding, and I like to run it along my quilt, and I know you're not going to be able to see all of it, but when I come to a corner here, I'm going to be doing some folding back and forth and stuff like that. So I just kind of mock it up, give myself some extra fabric, and continue to run this down. So I will do this down and around the whole quilt to make sure that none of those seams, there's another seam there, that's the first one I guess, that those seams do not fall at the corner, okay? What happens if they do fall at the corner? Well, what I will do in that case is I will start my binding somewhere else. I can either move it up or I can move it down. Either way will work, and it probably just needs to be moved a few inches, but that's what I would do. I always do this before I start stitching it down, because it's much easier to pretend than it is to take out stitches and have to move my binding. Okay? So Let's say I've decided to start my binding about here. Put that pin back in again. So, you know, you want to have at least 10 inches. If you have more, that's okay. Another reason to run your binding along the edge of the quilt is to make sure you have enough binding, okay? Because another thing you don't want to have happen is you get close to the edge and you run out of binding. Never a good thing, okay? So when I put this down here, because I'm using the binding tool today, I need to measure 12 inches from where I started my binding to where I'm going to stop it, okay? So let's measure. This happens to be a 12-inch ruler, very handy. And I'm just going to use a friction pen. You can use any kind of removable marker and just make a mark there. So I know when I have stitched all the way around, I need to stop my stitching and lock my stitches there. When I start and when I stop, I lock my stitches. So next thing I need to do is actually go to the sewing machine and get this binding sewn on. And I'm sewing it to the top of my quilt, and then it's going to be folded over to the back and hand stitched down to finish off that binding. So if you want to, you can either pin your binding as you go along, you could use clips on here, whatever you want to hold it in place. I typically do not, I just arrange it as I go along. The other thing I want to point out to you is when you come up to the corner, and you'll see this when I'm stitching, when I come up to the corner, I want to stop and lock my stitches a quarter inch away from the edge of my quilt. So I've made a little mark there so I can show myself where that is. You may have markings on your foot that you're using, that will help you with that. I suggest you use a walking foot if you've got that. I'm going to be doing that on my sewing machine. But you want to stop at that quarter inch mark and backstitch. You want to tack your stitches. And then we're going to take the quilt out and turn it and continue on. But I'll show you that at the sewing machine. So let's go to the machine and I'll show you how we start stitching this binding down. So I'm starting here. I've got this pin. So I'm just going to put my foot down. Take that pin out now. And I want to lock my stitches when I start here. I'm going to back stitch to do that. All right, so I'm just going to continue sewing this until I get to the corner, and then I want to show you what I'm going to do there. Remember, I'm going to stop a quarter inch away from the corner and tack my stitches. Lock your stitches. Lock your stitches. Okay, and I can pull my binding back a little bit and just see. Might want one more stitch there. All right, now I'm going to backstitch. And I'm going to cut my thread. Okay, so I'm actually going to take the quilt out of the machine and turn it so that I can now start stitching down the next side. But before I do that, I have some things I have to do. So what I need to do is I need to pull this binding back, okay? And we're forming a 45 degree angle here. Okay, you can see I've got this 45 degree angle. So I take it and I fold it up and away from my quilt on a 45 degree angle. So you can kind of play around with this a little bit. And then you want to have it come back down the side here of the quilt. And you're going to fold it so that this lines up along the top edge, in this case, the side edge of my quilt. Okay, and then I'm going to go down along here again. All right, I gotta line this up a little bit better here. There we go. So I can then, once that's all set up, I can then put my quilt back underneath. Okay, in this case, I do a little bit different. I do wanna lock my stitches here. I'm gonna go backwards first and then forward. It works better in this situation. And then forward. All right. And then I'm just going to keep going along this side till I come to the next corner. So I'm just going to keep going along here. And when I get towards the end and I'm going to be stopping my stitching on my binding, I'll stop and I'm going to show you what you need to do on those two binding strips that you left. You did leave a 10 inch strip, I hope, right? And you're going to do the same thing at the end. So I'm going to show you what you need to do next so that they will join together really nicely and form a perfect seam, and you won't even notice where you started or ended your binding. Okay. So I'm up to the place where I need to stop. So that's where the pin is there. So I'm going to stop and back stitch so I can lock my stitches. Okay, so now I can take the quilt out of the machine, and I've got that 12 inches between the place where I started and stopped, and you can see that I've got lots of a binding tail, which is great. I always prefer to have more than less. So let's go back to the cutting table and I'll show you how to use the binding tool to join these ends together. So I'm back at the cutting table and I wanted to show you the binding tool. That's what it's called, the binding tool, and it's made by the Quilters Mercantile Inc. So this is what it looks like. It's an acrylic tool and it's got some markings on it. It has instructions on it, but I found them a little difficult to follow. So I had to kind of play around at first to make sure I could get this working right, because, you know, once you've cut that binding strip, you know, you're kind of into, you know, that's, there's no going back kind of land. So this is what it looks like. And you're going to see that there's a line here that says mark here. There's an A here. There's a B here. And it will say on it, printed side always up. Okay. So we're not going to be flipping this over and having it backwards. Okay. You're always going to be using on this tied side. So you will sometimes be rotating it, but you always want to make sure that you can read those words, you know, that they're the right side up for you. Okay, so let's start with one side. Okay, we're going to start with this side here. So you're going to take the binding tool, you're going to butt it up against where you stopped sewing, okay, and you're going to take your excess binding and you're going to pull it across the tool to where that line says mark here, okay? So I'm marking with an erasable tool. I'm using my friction pen here, but I'm marking that line there, okay? You can mark it all the way along if you want. I don't think you need to have a ruler here or anything, but approximately, okay? Then you're going to open up your binding strip. So this is the right side of my fabric here, all right? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, to open this up so I've got some room here. Okay, and lay it down flat, get it off your quilt because you're gonna do some cutting here. At this point in time, you're gonna take the B mark, and I'm lining this tool up along my strips. You can see that it's 2.5 inches wide as well. So I'm going to line it up and then I'm going to cut it along this line. Okay, you'll notice there's a little cut off, the tip's cut off, that'll make it join up easier. And we're cutting along here. All right, there we go. So one side is cut. Now don't worry about the mark that I put on here, that's going to come off when I iron it. I'm going to do that in a few minutes. All right, so we've got that there. Get it out of the way. Okay, you want to make sure things are out of the way, that we're not cutting into our quilt, that we're not cutting into the other binding strip. Okay, just some warnings. Now I had this like this. I'm going to turn it around. So this flat side is what we're using all the time against our stitching. So again, we've got the flat side there against where we actually started the binding. We're going to move the binding strip on top of it. And we've got another mark to make here. Okay, so we've got that mark there. You could do a better job than I'm doing. I'm just wanting to make sure I can see that line. Okay, so now this is where you do not want to use that mark here strip. Okay, we're not using that mark here strip for cutting at all. All right, we're using the A and B's when we're cutting. We already cut using the B. Now we're going to cut using the A. And so this is on the opposite side. Now, this gets a little tricky for me to cut. All right, but I would be cutting up here and here. I don't want to wreck this, so I'm going to move it around so it's easier for me to cut. So I'm just going to move it a little bit here, all right, because you always like to be safe, right? You always like to be safe in the studio. So I know where this is going to go. I'm just going to open it up a little bit more, okay? Remember, the A is going to go along there. Line up that tool along your binding, okay? And then I'm going to cut, all right? So I'm cutting up along there and cutting on that angle. See what I mean about being careful not to get too close to your quilt? Or not cutting your quilt, I should say. Oops, I'm still not cutting through here. Seem to be, there we go, having a bit of a problem there. Okay. All right, so I've got these cut. Let me move my quilt back again, which makes it easier for you to see. So I've got the two pieces cut, all right? So now what we need to do is we need to join these up right sides together and stitch them together with a 1/4 inch seam, okay? So I'm gonna go to the sewing machine to do that, but before I do that, I want to put them together, all right? So you're probably gonna wanna pin them. Maybe you wanna use a little bit of seam-align glue, which is one of my favorite products. But in any case, you want to line these up, and this is where cutting off those tips really helped a lot. And again, having this excess, not a good pin, having the excess binding strips left over at the beginning and at the end really helps in this situation, because otherwise, you know, if you don't have much, you're kind of all crunched up trying to line things up, and that's never a good thing. Okay, and we're going to line this little guy up here. I need to move this over a bit. I'm not doing a good job, but you get the idea of what I'd be doing. So I'd be lining these up, and then I'm going to stitch along here, and then you'll be able to stitch the binding right down flat onto your quilt. So let's go to the machine and do that, and we'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so now I'm going to be using a quarter inch seam allowance and just sewing these two binding strips together, binding edges really. All right, so let's get this in here under my needle at the right spot. Okay. It's a little area to work in here, so take your time. And keep my fingers crossed that this all turned out okay, which it did. So we've got them nicely lined up there. I used some seam allowance glue to hold them together so they wouldn't fall apart. Okay, so I just want to give this a quick press open, and then I'll show you how I finished stitching it at the machine. Okay, so I've got the binding edges, or start and finish, sewn together, okay? So now I need to stitch that opening that we left, that 12 inch opening, I need to stitch that down so the binding will be all sewn to the front of the quilt. So let's do that now. So I need to go back over here, and we're going to lock our stitches here. So go forward and backward. And then I just need to stitch along with that quarter inch seam till I meet up at the other edge. Okay, here we go. All right, stitch is locked. Cut my thread. And there we go. And that's all nicely sewn down. Worked pretty good, I gotta say. Okay, so we've got the binding on the front of the quilt, but the binding isn't really all done yet, is it? I mean, the quilt isn't bound yet, right? So we need to do something about that, don't we? So the next thing I like to do is, or that you have to do, is you have to fold the binding to the back of the quilt. But what I like to do is I like to open up my binding and I like to press it away from the quilt. So that helps to get it going towards the back of the quilt. And then once I've done that, I'm going to fold it over and I need to hand stitch it along. So I'm going to go press it, and then I'll show you how I hand stitch the binding down onto the back of the quilt. So now I'm ready to hand stitch the binding to the back of the quilt. Remember I told you I was going to press the binding to the, press it away from the quilt. So I did that. And then I also used seam align glue to, you know, temporarily glue this all down. You could use clips or pins, whatever you want, to hold the binding in place as you stitch along. It's helpful to have it down, like that in some fashion, as you move along. So I just want to show you how I do this. I'll show you a little bit how I do it. One thing I wanted to point out too, at the corners, you'll find when you press it back away that the corners will automatically fold a certain direction. So you can see that the corner is folding, let me just see here, folding in this direction, I believe. And so on the back, I want to do it in the opposite direction. So I'm folding, you know, this is going down first, this side is going down first, and this one's folding over top of it. Just reduces the bulk at the corners. Okay, so to start off, I just have some regular, it's the same thread I use for piecing. It's a 50 or 60 weight, I forget, I think it's a 50 weight cotton thread. And I just make sure I put a knot in the end of it. And I like to start kind of underneath. Okay, so I'm going to go through the quilt, just get a little bit of it there, and just to get that knot buried underneath the binding. And then what I do is I come up and I want to take my needle and I want to put it right through the folded edge of that binding, okay? And I push it through and I'm taking probably a little bit more than a quarter inch. I'm not fussy about it. And then I'm going to come down into the quilt. Make sure you don't go through the quilt to the front. You don't want to see your stitches on the front. And I'll just pull that along. And then I'll go right back in again to that fold. This is the hardest part for me, to go in the fold and go along again, come out, and go down into the quilt. So there's different ways you can stitch the binding on. I like this. I find it doesn't show very much at all. It's secure enough because I'm getting quite a bit of fabric from the binding and also from the quilt. Some people just take very little tiny bits of it. You know, whatever your preference is. What I am trying to do is make sure that the binding is securely attached to the quilt and that my stitching doesn't show. And I don't think it's really showing very much there. So that's good. So I would just do this, go all the way along. And when you're done, you're going to tie off your quilt or your stitches, obviously. But the other thing you may want to do is to go back in. I don't always do this, but you may want to go in and sew that diagonal seam on the front and the back, just a few little stitches there to make sure everything's down and nothing's going to come apart. So when I'm done here, I'm going to have my quilt all bound. And I know you won't be able to see this all of it anyway, but you can get an idea of what it looks like. So I think that yellow works pretty well there. And you've got the nice binding all done on it, all securely stitched to the back of your quilt. And then your quilt is all done. Thanks so much for watching today. If you are one of my subscribers and have been following along with me, thank you so much for watching my videos. And if you would like to support the Chatterbox Quilts YouTube channel, you can do so by donating as little as $2. If you look below the video, you're going to see that there's a heart with a dollar sign in it, and that's where you can click and donate whatever you would like to the Chatterbox Quilts YouTube channel. It really helps me to buy the supplies I need to produce these free videos for you. Thanks so much for watching today. Please give this video a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. And before you go, check out these other videos I've included just for you. For more helpful quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.